baseball fans, and welcome. Major League Baseball on tap. It's the Miami Marlins taking on the San Francisco Giants. John Ciambi, Chris Singleton with you. Singy, this might be my favorite ballpark in the game.
Just looking out over the bay, seeing the boats in the water. Beautiful ballpark, a great atmosphere. Don't get it twisted. San Francisco Giants fans, bring it.
And we'll be back with the first pitch right after this. About to get started here. And now here's the starter for San Francisco, Hayden Birdsong. But Chris, he hasn't exactly been stellar here on his home mound.
Well, I'll say this. Every player wants to perform well at their home ballpark, in front of their fans, in front of the city. And you know this guy, no different. He wants to be more effective here. So, you know, you look at the numbers. They haven't been great at home. I'm sure he wants to turn that around, and we'll see if he's able to start that in this one.
And the 1-0.
2-0.
And fires in a fastball at 95. And a foul ball. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout. Now here's the Marlins DH, Jesus Sanchez. Just off the outside edge. Sanchez goes 6 feet, 3 inches, 220 pounds, and he's usually in the outfield. Today he's the DH.
Get out of here, Marlins.
Left-hand hitter waits. And there's a ball.
You know, Boog, people don't realize how far the jog is from the dugout to the outfield position. And if you're playing in Oakland, man, it's a country mile to get out there. So for him to be able to be the DH today, that is really a nice day off.
One out, base is empty. And it's ball four. He missed down low.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted him first base with a quick free pass.
So man aboard, and now the first baseman, Jake Berger. That one misses. That's five straight. The pitch. And a foul ball. The pitch. Center field. McCray under it. He's got it. There's two away.
Batting four.
And time now for the Marlins lineup. This is an offense, Chris, that's having a hard time scoring runs right now.
Yeah, sometimes things just aren't going to click. And unfortunately, what happens is players press. They try to do a little bit more, and they get out of their game. You've got to let the game come to you. If you chase it, it's going to run from you. So this is a team that just needs to calm down, relax, and understand that they're going to come out of this.
Now, here is Kyle Stowers. Next offering in there for a strike.
One and one.
And it's 1-1. Sanchez, the runner at first with two gone. The 1-1 is fouled off. Swings through it, and that's a strikeout. One left for Miami. Now it's the Giants' turn. No score. You're watching Major League Baseball exclusively on the show. Back here in San Francisco, and on the hill, the big righty, Edward Cabrera.
Well, coming into this game, hitters are batting under 250 against this starting pitcher. So it just shows you how effective he's been. He's been able to move his pitches around, add and subtract, change up the look so that hitters don't get too comfortable and start squaring up the baseball. We'll see what he's got in this one.
We go to the bottom of the first. Here's Lamont Wade Jr. And a pitch. Ball one there. The ground. Brujan gathers and throws to first. One up, one down.
Batting second.
Now we take a peek at the Giants lineup. One guy leading the way offensively for this club right now, Elliot Ramos.
And he's leading them in runs batted in this season, which tells me this guy is able to slow things down when it seems like there's a little bit of pressure, and he's looking at it as an opportunity to do damage. You know, a lot of guys, they see runners on base and they get big. They feel like all this pressure, I've got to get these runs in, but somehow he seems to settle into these situations. So watch out when he comes to the plate.
One down, base is empty. Lifted in the air, right center field. Konai under it. Two away now.
Hey, man, four pitches, two outs. That is an excellent pace.
Batting third, the designated hitter.
Here's Elliot Ramos.
Ramos.
And there's a strike. Pitch misses there, and one, two out, space is empty. Wouldn't chase that time.
Last couple of pitches, breaking balls away. I think he's going to have to come firm inside to be able to open up that location if he wants to go back there later in this count.
Hard ground ball, base knock. So a two out knock keeps the inning alive.
Well, patience and discipline paid off right there as he got into an advantage count. He wasn't able to elevate it, but he put a great swing on it. Right on time, good balanced approach, and just blasted it through the infield.
And here is Michael Conforto. First pitch misses. And another ball.
He doubled up on the off speed there. We talk about the power fastball, but he's working a little differently here.
Next offering in there for a strike. That's strike one.
It's amazing to look up and see 88 miles per hour on that changeup. Back in the day, that was a pretty good fastball. But with high velocities these days, that speed differential is right where it needs to be.
Two outs. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. That one missed.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score it.
Outside, and that is ball four.
Got a great back and forth in that at bat. He had to lay off some really close pitches, and somehow, Boogie, he found a way to keep the bat on his shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
Now it's Matt Chapman. Ball one, no strikes. Two on, two outs, and fouled off. That one finds the corner. Gonna count one and two. First and second, two down. Not even close there. Ball two. Wouldn't chase that time.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
Patrick Bailey on deck for San Francisco. Foul ball, and it remains a full count. And a pitch. And he walked him. That's a great at bat. He saw a lot of pitches and earned a walk.
Oh, that sets up a really big at bat in this game. These are the moments when everyone in the stadium gets really locked in.
Two outs, bases full. Patrick Bailey, the next Giant to hit.
And takes low for ball one.
Ramos at third, Conforto at second, Chapman at first, two out of the inning. Out in front with the swing, and that is strike one.
Filthy changeup right there. Just pulled the string.
Kicks and deals. Base hit. One run is in. The throw in. In there safely. It's 2-0.
His confidence level is so high. Really nice job of coming through in a big spot.
Other than ripping one into the gap or blasting one over the wall, there aren't a whole lot of hits that are more satisfying than a nice line drive in the center field. So that definitely felt good.
First and second, two outs. Now it's the right fielder. Not close with that one. Ball one. Fouled off. He was late. Tough start for him so far. Already at 30 pitches here in the first. And strike two.
Oh, that's that slurp right there. He threw it extremely well. Talk about just a ton of breaks. So tough to get that barrel to.
Next offering upstairs. Right-hander kicks, deals. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. The pitch. They tried to get him to chase on a slider down and away. Outside, and that is ball four. Two outs, bases loaded. Grant McCray digs in now. That one finds the zone. 0-1. Kicks and fires. And a breaking ball drops in for a strike.
And a bat like this is almost over as it begins. In this situation, you have no idea what the next pitch is going to be. You just got to hope that you can make contact.
Swing and a miss, struck him out. And that'll keep more runs from coming in, inning over. But two runs for him, and they jump ahead. We head to the second from San Francisco. It's the Giants 2 and the Marlins nothing. Second inning set to go. And now for the Marlins, Derek Hill. Birdsong back to work. Fastball for a strike. Righty delivers.
Ball.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
And that one is lifted in the air under it. Makes the grab. And there's one down.
That is good. The right fielder,
And up next for Miami, Griffin Konat. Good power, not great in the OBP department. Swings through that.
0-1.
And ball one. Carl Dixon doing the umpiring behind the plate.
And Boog, I'm not sure if it's because he sort of sets up higher than most, but one thing to be aware of with Dixon is the high strike. Not usually a big deal because most players are swinging at pitches up there, but we may see some surprise looks from hitters from time to time because that's just so unusual.
The Giants leading by two here at the top of the second. Swing and a fly ball in the air out towards right center field. McCray snags it for the second out.
Batting seven, the second baseman.
So up next, Otto Lopez. And the first pitch misses for ball one. And that's in for a strike. At the belt and fires. Bounce to the left side. Fitzgerald sends it across to first. Out number three. Miami down in order. They trail it here 2-0. And welcome back to the ballpark. Now it's the second baseman, Tyro Estrada. This is a guy who's in the lineup first and foremost because of what he contributes defensively, Chris. And when you talk about preventing runs from being scored, this guy is a big contributor. And Estrada is out. And a quick out number one.
Now batting, the first baseman.
So here's Wade now. He's 0 for 1.
Junior.
Pitch misses inside, and it's 1-0. Singy, he wasn't real sharp in the first, got hit around, but really more so, didn't throw a ton of strikes.
Well, he's just got to find a way to settle down. He was clearly fighting himself out there, not really finding the strike zone, walking batters. So we'll see if he can get back on track and fill up the zone a little bit more.
Well, usually a high level of confidence when you're facing a young pitcher out there on the mound. In this situation, ahead 2-0, he's put himself in a really good spot.
The wind of the pitch. Swing and a miss. Nice changeup.
2 balls, 2 strikes.
He goes down looking.
Well, definitely a borderline pitch right there, and he didn't look too convinced as he headed back to the dugout. You know, those are tough ones to let go as a hitter, but with the human umpire calling balls and strikes, it's always going to be on you to protect yourself with 2 strikes.
Fitzgerald in now, takes ball one off the plate. And a pitch.
Aye.
That two one not close. Strike. Now 2 balls and a strike. Swing and a foul over the screen and back out of play. Sharp grounder, that's through for a base hit. And that keeps the inning alive.
He was all over that one.
Just kept it simple, played pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from, and there's just no one there to knock it down.
And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Ramos in the box now, no balls and a strike. Fitzgerald leads off first with two down to the inning. Way outside, and that's ball one.
0-2 pitch that far out of the zone gives the hitter a little confidence that maybe he can climb back into this at bat.
Cabrera throws over. Fitzgerald back on a dive. Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out.
The left fielder, number 8, Michael.
Michael Conforto will climb in. First offering, and it just misses. The pitch. Misses just off the outside edge. I think that was a strike.
And that's a pitch early in this game. He needs called for a strike. Struggling with command issues. He's got to get a little help from the umpire.
The Giants trying to break this one open. Bottom half of inning number 2. And that's off the inside edge. And that's ball 3. Matt Chapman waits to bat for the Giants. Two outs. Liner, base hit. Coming home. Fires it to the plate. He's safe.
Well, when you fall behind in the count, you've got to come into the zone, and then guys have a better chance of hitting the ball hard like he did right there.
So two on with two away. And here is Matt Chapman. Worked a walk in his first trip to the plate. Matt Chapman, big blast, left field. And that one is off the wall. One run across. Now the throw comes in. Runner holds it third.
Well, that started and ended pretty quickly. No messing around right there. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. Ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
So two down, and up next for the Giants, Patrick Bailey. Just missed.
Big moment in this game. Two outs, two runners in scoring position, and could really break this thing wide open early.
Two on, two outs. Strike one. And he hits a ground ball right side. Over to first. That ends the inning and stops things from getting out of hand. So it's two runs on four hits. No errors and a couple left on. We head on now to the top of the third. It's the Giants 4 and the Marlins nothing. Top half of the third inning. And now it's Vidal Brujan.
Vidal Brujan.
And a pitch. And first offering is fouled off. Here comes a pitch. And now it's even up. That one the other way. And that's down, a base hit. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Digging in, number 47. There's the strike. Runner at first with no outs here. And it's even up.
Outside.
Swing and a miss as he chases that one darting out of the zone.
Two strikes.
And a foul ball. He stays alive.
You could see he was trying to stay back long enough to handle the off-speed pitch, but just a little tardy on the fastball.
Off the mark there. The count now 2-2. And down on strikes. One out.
Came inside with that two-strike fastball nicely and just bunched him up on the inside part of the plate. Couldn't get around on it and catch it out front. Many times if you do, it's a foul ball. And you know, a lot of pitchers, they really don't like working inside with two strikes because they do not want to hit that batter. And when they've got him up against the ropes, got to figure out a way to put him away. Did a nice job right there.
2-0.
And a pitch out, but nothing going on. Next offering is in for a strike. He swings and fouls one off.
Clearly hoping he could get a swing and miss on that, but doesn't fool the hitter with that breaking ball. Nice job, just couldn't keep it fair.
Righty to the plate. On the ground, a second, might be two. Good feed, that's one. Double play, and that'll do it for the inning. No runs, one hit, no errors, and no one left. We move on to the bottom of inning number three. It's the Giants 4 and the Marlins nothing. As we go to the last of the third and digging in for San Francisco, number 59, the wind of the pitch. Wouldn't chase that time.
I think this is an important inning on the mound for him in this game. He's got to find a way to settle things down and give some length in this start.
Outside low, and that's ball two. Activity in the bullpen. Number 62 getting ready to go. The wind to kick the 2-0. The other way, puts it away for the out.
It's never fun going back to the dugout after hitting a line drive that finds a glove, but you will get some high fives. You know, when you make great contact, you feel like you've done everything right. But in this game of baseball, not everything is in your control.
McCray at the plate now. That's ball one. And a swing and a miss.
1-1.
One down, base is empty. Swings through that one for strike two.
They can live up in the zone all game if hitters will chase it. That's just too much velocity. Hitters got to look down in the zone.
And another ball.
Two strike.
Bounce to the right, Berger. Takes it himself, and two straight set down to begin the bottom of the third.
The second baseman, Tyro Estrada.
Tyro Estrada to the plate. Flied to right his first time. Ball one, no strikes. Wouldn't chase that time. Two down, nobody on. Now 3-0. Top of the zone, and it's called a strike. The 3-1. Swing and a foul straight back. To the right side, dives, and he can't hang on. No play, that's an infield single.
Now batting, the first baseman.
So the lineup flips over, and up next for San Francisco, runner takes off, pitch inside. throw to second. Ow! And that'll end the inning.
The catcher definitely looked ready for that stolen base attempt. Got in position quickly and a strike down to second base to end the inning.
Out of the fourth and at the plate for Miami, Jesus Sanchez.
Jesus Sanchez.
And here it comes. That one finds the zone, and it's 0-1. On the ground right side, and it finds its way through for a hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Now batting, the first baseman.
Dominant performance for him today, Boo. Just two hits allowed so far, no runs across either, and he's had an answer for just about every hitter he's faced, so I don't think this hit is going to knock him off his stride too much.
Man at first, and the batter now, Jake Berger. That one's upstairs, ball one. Berger, in his second season, 27 years old, and they went out and made a trade for him last season. Nobody out, runner at first. In for a strike, and it's 1-1. Swing and a miss as he was out
one
front
ball,
that time.
Two strike.
And a 1-2. And they'll do it again. Pitch.
2-2 the count.
This one in the dirt. Runner holds tight as the count moves to 2-2. The Giants leading by 4. Top half of inning number 4. Got him looking. Fastball at the letters. Frozen for strike 3.
Now batting.
And here is Kyle Stowers. 0-1. He struck out swinging last time. And it's fouled away.
Come on, Giants.
And the right-hander deals. In the air, pretty deep out to center field. Makes the catch for the out. So, man aboard. And now for the Marlins, Derek Hill. He's 0-1.
One oh.
In the dirt. And the runner stays where he is. Sanchez off of first with two away. And another ball. Next offering is in for a strike. And that one missing low.
Here's an opportunity to do some damage and perhaps unlock this offense. 3-1 count. Be ready to turn on a fastball.
The pitch. And that one fouled off. The pitch popped up. Catcher tosses the mask, settles under it, nabs it, and that'll do it. Marlins leave one. They trail it here 4-0. Welcome back, and they turn to a new arm as we kick off the bottom of the fourth. Number 62.
Still pretty early in the ball game, so this bullpen has some work ahead of him. Best case scenario might be if he can come in here and get several quick outs, kind of bridge the gap that starter left for him.
And first offering is fouled off. Left-hand batter waits.
Aye.
And that's in the dirt.
Two strikes.
Foul ball still, a 1-2 count. Caught him looking for the K.
Oh, just a beautiful fastball on the inside corner for that backwards K right there. I think the hitter saw it all the way coming from that opposite arm angle. So I got to think he was looking away and just got locked up by the hard stuff boring in on his hands.
And the batter will be the shortstop, Tyler Fitzgerald. In there for a strike at the bottom of the zone. The 0-1.
Nope. Ball one.
Base is empty, one away. We're here in the bottom of the fourth. Breaking ball inside. And a count 2-1. That's a little bit low.
Three balls, one strike.
One down, base is empty. This to center field. Hill drifts towards it, puts it away for the out.
Now batting, the designated hitter, Elias Ramos.
Two outs, base is empty. Next will be the Giants DH, Elliot Ramos. And that's off the inside edge. And that is ball one. Wouldn't chase that time. Two outs. That one fouled off. A wind in the pitch. That misses. And now 3-1. Two down, nobody on. And down on strikes he goes. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Nothing across here this half. We played four. It's the Giants 4 and the Marlins nothing. And we're back. Top five, John Schaube with Chris Singleton. And leading it off, Griffin Konat. Birdsong back to work. And that one just misses, a ball and no strikes.
You know, these Marlins just aren't putting great swings on the baseball in this one. They're trying to find ways to drive the ball with some authority, but it's just not happening for them so far. Zero extra base hits in the game, so it's been tough for them to get anything going. Sometimes you have to keep chipping away until you break through, but it's a lot easier to put runs on the board when you have guys in scoring position because they put themselves there.
Fights that one away, still 1-2. And he deals.
Two balls, two strikes.
Out towards right center field. Sizes this one up. He's got it. And there's one down.
Now batting. Second baseman.
So digging in, Otto Lopez. And that's in for a strike. And a foul ball.
Let's go, Giants.
Strike.
That one lifted to left. And it's caught for the out.
Up next for the Marlins, the shortstop.
Two outs, base is empty. Brujan. And up next for Miami, Vidal Brujan. And he's already singled in this game. That misses. Ball one. Swing and a foul back. That's out of play.
Instead of letting the hitter get his arms extended, tied him up a little bit, slightly up, slightly in.
Two outs. Fly ball down the line. Dives, but it's off his glove. Base hit. Throws to second. Not in time. He's got a double. A
couple of hits in a row for him here. Could be a chance here for them to start clawing back into this ballgame.
Here's the catcher. His first at bat was a strikeout. That one hammered but pulled foul. Two outs and one in scoring position. Not even close there. And it's one and one. And the righty deals. Off the mark there. Two and two. Swings and misses. Pat him out front for strike three. Still nothing on the scoreboard for him after five. It's the Giants four and the Marlins nothing. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Here's the left fielder, Michael Conforto. The right-hander back to work. That misses the zone, and that's ball one.
All these Giants putting together some really good at-bats in this game. There's been a lot to like with how they're approaching their chances at the plate. It looked to me like they really wanted to get to the starter early, get him out of the game before he settles in. So I'd say mission accomplished.
Into right, and that's a base hit. And the leadoff man aboard.
That's back-to-back singles for him. Nice line drive to the pole side. Met it out front, but just stayed through it nice enough and ripped it into the outfield.
Here's Matt Chapman.
Drove it off the wall last time. Just missed out on a home run.
Not close with that one. 1-0. There goes the runner. Swing and a ball lifted to center field. Hill makes the catch, and there's one gone.
The catcher, number 14, Patrick Bailey.
Man at first. Now, Patrick Bailey. 1-for-2 with a two-run single back in the first. Runner takes off on the ground to third. Fires across the diamond. No chance at the double play with the runner in motion.
Now batting, right fielder.
And now the right fielder. There's a foul ball. Conforto on its second with two down. Next offering way off the plate. And the pitch. Fought off foul. Man on second, two down. Swing and a ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. Around third. Here's the throw to the plate. Safe.
Puts a run on the board and picks up an RBI. Once you get the ball by the pitcher, there's a lot of base hits up the middle, even on ground balls. So a nice job to use that big hole and get himself a hit.
And up next for the Giants, Grant McCray. That's in there. It's 0-1. One run across in the frame so far. Last half of inning number five. And a pitch. Fights that one away, and the count remains 0-2. The pitch. Swing and a ball hit out towards left center field. Stowers makes a nice running catch, but the RBI single pushes across a run, and the lead is now 5-0. Back after this on the show. All right, we go to the top half of inning number six. Here's the third baseman, Connor Norby.
Norby.
The pitch. And first offering is fouled off. Kicks and fires. Strike two.
And it really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
Fights it off. He'll see another. Here's a high fly ball out to center. Drifts towards it. And there's one down. Jesus Sanchez getting ready to hit. That one out to right, moving under this one. Pulls it down, and there's two gone.
Now batting, the first baseman, Jake.
Two outs, base is empty. Jake Berger, the next to hit. And it skips in the dirt. The Giants leading by five, and we're at the top half of the sixth. And there's a ball. Swing and a miss.
Well, he came right at it right there, challenged him with the 2-0 fastball. Not sure exactly what he was looking for, but got to imagine that's a confidence booster on the mound. You're in that hitter's head a little bit.
Makes the grab, and that's the inning. Make it six shutout innings for him out there now. It's the Giants 5 and the Marlins nothing. New pitcher for the Marlins, Mike Bauman.
And with the big deficit on the scoreboard, he almost has to just put that out of his mind. Every outing matters for relievers and their numbers, but I think it's tough to get up for this type of appearance the same way you would for one in a close game.
Leading up.
And digging in for San Francisco, Tyro Estrada, one for two.
Estrada.
As he turns on the rubber, and with that good live arm delivers. Pitch misses there. Ball one.
And another ball.
Boog, he never moved because he never had time to. But that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
Just off the outside edge, and that's ball three. And there's ball four.
You get a walk, and you get a walk. Everyone gets a walk, boo.
Lamont Wade Jr. now at the plate, 0-for-3 with two strikeouts and a ground out. Wouldn't chase that time. Movement in the bullpen. A right-hander appears to be getting loose. Estrada gets his lead at first. Nobody out. Right through there for a strike. That one misses, and it's 2-1. There's a swing and a miss.
Well, the hitter shows the pitcher that he's willing to go after that pitch down in the zone. So perhaps he'll come back to it. Still try to get that ground ball double play.
Come on, Giants.
Kicks and deals. Rolled to short, possible two ball. Over to second for one, and that's two.
Well, almost any time you roll over and send a two ball to short at this level, you can pretty much count on a double play. Middle infielders are just so reliable, and they work on these plays all the time, so it almost becomes like second nature.
Fitzgerald, the next to hit, takes ball one. Two down, nobody on, here in the bottom of the sixth. There's a strike.
One ball, one strike.
In the air, right side. Konine under this one. He's there. He's got it. And that is that. Back here at Oracle Park, new inning getting started. Now at the plate, Kyle Stowers.
The left fielder, Kyle Stowers.
Birdsong back to work.
Yeah.
And a swing and a miss.
He's been very consistent with his command out there on the mound, consistently throwing at the knees. Pretty impressive when a guy can repeat his delivery like this.
Left-hand hitter waits. That one way inside. And a pitch. And that's off the inside edge. 2-1. Double-barreled action in the bullpen. Camilo Doval getting ready to come in for Bob Melvin. Miller, a left-hander, also throwing. Here comes a pitch.
Aye.
Line and caught at third by Chapman. The Gold Glover makes the play.
That swing right there tells me he's seeing the ball pretty well. I know it didn't produce a hit, but he made solid contact, and that's all you're looking to do anytime you're at the plate.
Hill in the box again, takes a strike.
0-1's the count.
Swing and a miss as he was out front.
Another 0-2 count right here. Pitcher just in the driver's seat. He can go anywhere he wants to go right here.
Got him looking. That's a strikeout.
Really love the pitch sequence right there. I'm telling you what, pitcher and catcher on the same page right now.
Griffin Konine.
So two down now, and here is Griffin Konine. And that's outside, and that's ball one. Right-hander kicks, deals. Foul ball. Off the plate, inside. And it's 2-1. Swings and blasts one deep to left center. And it hops over the wall for an automatic double.
Well, there's something really nice about getting yourself an automatic double like that. You get to stroll into second base without having to worry about a throw or getting your uniform dirty. And now you're just looking for the next hitter to kind of do the same thing. Maybe put one in the gap so you can jog home as well.
And now Otto Lopez. And there's a strike. And now the 0-1. And a foul ball. Righty to the plate. Just off the inside corner. And the count 1-2. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again.
Just one out away from seven strong innings and just at 100 pitches. Man, pretty impressive. They've got to be happy with what they've gotten from him out there today.
Yep. 2-2 now. Swing and a miss, and he got him. Picks up strikeout number 7. One left for Miami. It's 5-0. Set for the last half of the 7th, and now the DH, Elliot Ramos.
With this kind of lead, he can swing freely, try to hit the ball out of the park, do what he loves to do.
The why to kick the pitch. And that one pulled foul. Bauman, 28 years old. They got him off of waivers earlier this season. The why to the pitch. Ball one there.
And that's awfully close. I don't know how you take that. He's seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand really well right now.
The next pitch misses, and it's 2-2.
2 balls, 2 strikes.
In the air, left field, down the line. Stowers drifts towards it. Hauls it in, and there's one away.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
Conforto in the box with one away as he takes ball one. Base is empty, one away. Here at the bottom of the 7th. And another ball.
Ball two.
Wouldn't chase that time.
No strike.
And there's the strike. And that's ball four.
That's ball four.
Pretty easy walk right there. Last pitch wasn't even much to think about.
Now batting.
One gone runner at first.
Matt
Chapman, the next Giant to hit.
Stay out of the double play.
And that's outside. Man at first, one away. The next offering misses, and the count is 2-0. Right-handed reliever, and
ball
downstairs.
Three. I got 3-0.
Let's go, Giants!
Next offering in there for a strike. Three balls and a strike. Right through there for a strike. Conforto, the base runner at first with one out. And there's a rocket into the outfield. They get it in quickly. So first and second, now one out.
Man, those are the types of hits where you don't feel any vibration in your hands whatsoever. Such a good feeling.
Nice line drive to the pole side right there, but he didn't spin off of it. That's the key. You still have to extend through the baseball in order to hit a line drive like that.
And now here is Patrick Bailey. Hit in the air, center field. Hill has this one sized up. Hill makes the catch.
The batter, the right fielder, Gerard Encarnacion.
So first and second with two outs. Now it's the right fielder. Fastball for a strike. 0-1. Two outs, a couple of base runners at first and second. Right through there for a strike.
He doesn't seem to like to pitch up. Hasn't offered on either one of those pitches. 0-2 count now. I think the guy's going to climb the ladder out there.
And the right-hander deals. Bounced up the middle. Into the outfield, base hit. Around third. Now a long throw home. He's safe.
Picks himself up an RBI. Timing on the swing was good. Able to shoot the ball up the middle. Didn't square it up as much as he probably would have liked, but that's a good approach paying off.
Grant McCray, the next Giant to hit. 0-3. A fly out, a ground out, and a strikeout.
That's a ball.
First pitch doesn't find the zone. Two on, two outs.
Outside, that's a ball.
Could be some action here on this next pitch. Couple runners on. Probably a challenge pitch coming.
That's off the mark, and that's ball three. Fastball for a strike. Swings and misses, and now 3-2.
When you throw a fastball by a guy like that, I imagine it's got to feel incredible. Look for him to throw it again at some point.
That one to first, Berger. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. Two men left stranded, but they do push across one. We look ahead to inning number eight. It's the Giants 6 and the Marlins nothing. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Camilo Doval.
And he's got a nice lead to work with, so he should come in throwing strikes, attacking these hitters.
Here's the shortstop at the plate. Vidal Brujan.
Vidal Brujan.
And a pitch. On the ground, right side. Estrada to first. Leadoff man is out here in the eighth.
Really nice job to get your first out of the ballgame.
Catcher, Ali Sanchez.
Now it's the Marlins catcher, who's 0-2 with a pair of strikeouts. Misses inside, and it's 1-0. Signs of movement in the Giants bullpen. Kyle Harrison appears to be getting ready, and I'm sure he's feeling some nerves. This would be his major league debut. And that one hit to first. And he takes it himself for the out.
The third baseman, number 24, Connor Norby.
So the batting order turns over. Connor Norby, the next up for the Marlins. First pitch, just misses. Two down, nobody on, and we're in the top of the eighth. And another ball. That one misses. 3-1 now.
Three balls, one strike.
There's a swing and a drive. And it's into the bleachers. Out of here. Home run number 5 on the season. And they've got their first run. It's 6-1.
That could be one of those swings that really helps spark this offense. The cutter up and in can be such a tough pitch for the hitters. You have to keep your hands above the baseball, and that's exactly what he did. He caught it out front and drove it out of here.
Next is the designated hitter, Jesus Sanchez. Hammers that one, curling down the line, and foul. Righty delivers. That missed by a lot. And the count is 1-1. And a swing and a miss there.
One ball, two strikes.
Keeps the at bat going with a foul ball. The 1-2. Popped up first base side. Wade has a beat on it. And puts the squeeze on that one. And that is that. One scores in the inning coming on this solo home run. And this is now a 6-1 ball game. It's Major League Baseball on the show. Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, number 66.
I think it's got to be a little tough coming in out of the pen when your guys are trailing so big on the scoreboard. Just doesn't have the same intensity to it, but he's got to find a way because these batters count the same for his stats, obviously, regardless of the score.
Here's the second baseman, Tyro Estrada. The pitch. That takes low for ball one.
Come on now, Jay.
The pitch. That two one ball, not close. One and it's 2-1. At the belt and fires. Fouls one off. 2-2. And a pitch. Now fly ball to right center. Konai should have this one. Hauls it in and there's one away.
The batter. The first baseman.
Back to the top of the lineup. And up next for San Francisco, Lamont Wade Jr. 0 for 4, 2 strikeouts and 2 groundouts. Fastball in for a strike, and it's 0-1. Meanwhile, Activity in the bullpen. Declan Cronin, the hard-throwing righty, is up and loosening. Base is empty, one away. Here, the bottom half of the eighth inning. Just missed.
Nasty backdoor slider. There's really nothing you can do with that if you swing at it. So that's a good take by him.
Next offering is in for a strike. One down, base is empty. Way inside, gets out of the way. The pitch. In the air, out towards left center. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. Two down.
Yeah, that's a tough play for the infielder, ranging back into the outfield. There's part of him that's saying, hey, where are you at, outfielder? Call me off. But he stayed focused and made a nice catch right there.
And first offering is fouled off. Two down, nobody on. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. Two outs. Stays alive. That's down and in. Ground ball, left side, and foul ball.
Well, he's having a tough time getting a pitch by him. As a hitter, you feel pretty confident that you're seeing different pitches, still able to make some type of contact.
Bows it off, still one and two.
Five foul balls in this at bat so far, and these two are going head to head. You can see the crowd. They're starting to get into it a little bit more. And
swing and a miss, and he struck him out. And a nice inning of work there as he sets him down 1-2-3. Nothing doing here this half. Ninth inning coming up. It's the Giants 6 and the Marlins 1. We go to the ninth. Stepping in, Jake Berger.
This kid picked up in a trade. A lot was offered and given to get him, but he's got a real high ceiling.
The 0-1 comes up empty. That's strike two. Action in the San Francisco bullpen. Kyle Harrison, the left-handed reliever, appears to be getting loose. Miller getting loose as well. And here it comes. Batted by him for the K.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically likes to shoot the ball the other way. But that time, a little anxious.
Kyle Stowers digs in now. And that's in for a strike.
That was absolute gas. Triple digits on the gun. It's just a different experience as a hitter watching that go by.
And ball one. The Giants leading by five here at the top of the ninth. Swing and a miss. And the count one and two.
Just not able to catch up to that velocity.
Lifted in the air, right center field. McCray under it. Makes the catch. And there's two away.
The batter, the center fielder.
Marlins down to their final out. And at the plate for Miami, Derek Hill. That misses. And that is ball one. Swing and a miss.
I got a ball, one strike.
Two down, nobody on. There's a strike.
One ball, two strikes.
This could end it. And a swing and a miss, and that is the ball game.
Playing meaningful games in September is always exciting. A win today, first day of the month. This will just add more fuel to the fire.
6-1 is your final here today. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Ciampi saying so long.